Hi, my name is Rachel Carter. I'm the Branch Vice President of Coldwell Banker Residential Brokerage in Alexandria, Virginia, and I'm also the Chair of the NVAR Standard Forms Committee.
And I'm Matt Troiani, Vice President of Professional Development and Chief Counsel for NVAR.
So thank you for joining us today. We wanted to talk a little bit about the brand new addendum that's come out in regard to the COVID-19 response. The committee came together very quickly over this because of the obvious need of these very unusual circumstances that we're all in to put together language in the form of an addendum that all agents can use to protect your sellers and buyers. This particular addendum goes into some detail. There's two sections essentially to it, and I'll let Matt talk a little bit more about the specific legal provisions. The first part of the addendum deals with an unforeseeable event. So this will be anything that happens beyond the party's reasonable control. In other words, what is going on outside of the contract in the parties and makes it impossible or impractical for them to consummate the contract or finish and settle the contract. So that would include things like this pandemic, governmental declarations, shutdowns, quarantines, those type of things. And this language is specific to that and gives your clients a little bit of added protection so that if there is a situation where they can't close, neither party would be in default. The second part of the contract or the addendum, numbers 3 and 4, deal with extension options. So while both parties can always agree to extend any portion of the contract or extend settlement, this particular addendum allows you to be specific. So you can choose to delay the entire contract, including all of the dates and settlement, or you can look at specific extensions for specific contingencies. So it gives you a lot of flexibility. Matt, would you like to add anything?
Thanks, Rachel. No, absolutely. And I think consistent with the guidance that we've been providing to our members for best practices during this time is more important than ever to continue to communicate with your client, communicate with the other side, communicate with lenders and settlement agents and all the parties to the transaction. And this form is really designed in order to try to facilitate both the formation and ratification of a contract, as well as provide the types of flexibility that Rachel mentioned. So the first section clearly is intended to be signed either during contract ratification or afterward if you're already ratified and the parties are willing to agree on the mutual additional protections. These are all designed for things that are beyond their reasonable control or otherwise unforeseeable. And what it means is that the contract is still binding, but if for some reason due to these forces beyond their control, the parties are not able to perform, the contract is neither party is going to be in default under the contract. But also consistent with our best practices, we want to avoid a one-size-fits-all approach. What we are trying to emphasize here is that the most important thing that you can do is be mindful of what the parties are trying to accomplish. Are the parties trying to both get out of the contract? Then they can negotiate a mutual release. This does nothing to stop that. If the parties are willing to entertain extensions of certain deadlines, they can do that or simply extend the settlement date. Much like the inspection contingency removal addendum, this document can be used several times throughout the transaction. You're able to keep track of those by a number up in the corner. Most importantly, it's designed in order to allow you to, in one instance, you could extend a home inspection deadline. In a later instance, you could extend settlement date or a financing deadline. But the most appropriate thing is to make sure that it is relevant to your specific transaction. So if you have any other questions on this, please feel free to contact the legal hotline. Rachel and I are also pleased to announce that we are going to be holding a digital lunch and learn on next Monday. See more details that are attached to this video for registration, but it's going to be at 12:30 and we will go over the contract in greater detail as well as answer questions from the membership.
Yes, thank you for joining us. Again, we're doing this so that you don't have to come up with language on your own and be in a difficult position of trying to, or being placed in a position of being attorney for your client, because that's not what we do as realtors. So this document is intended to help you navigate the next few weeks and months ahead. So thank you very much, and we look forward to seeing more of you on Monday.
Thank you, everybody. Have a great weekend and stay safe.